Let's start standard 7th mathematics exercise 1.2. Let's start standard 7th mathematics exercise 1.2. First question, write down a pair of integers whose sum is minus 7. Now we have to write down a pair of integers. Whose sum is minus 7. Sum means addition of two integers. Let's see. There are so many possibilities to have the answer as minus 7. I have written few over here. So minus 5 plus minus 2. Plus minus will be minus and then minus minus will be added. So minus 5 plus minus 2 is equals to minus 7. So this is the first way you can find the answer as minus 7. Or you can also say as minus 10 plus 3. So here minus plus, again there will be minus and bigger number is 10. So 10 minus 3 will be 7 and the negative sign to the answer will be applied. So the answer is minus 7. There are so many ways to get the answer as minus 7. These are the two examples I have given you in this answer. Let's go to the next one. Find the difference is minus 10. We have to write two integers in such a way that the difference, the answer by difference means subtraction. While subtracting, we get the answer as minus 10. So the difference means subtraction, or you can say as minus. So let's see first one, minus 6, minus 4. Now minus minus is plus, so minus 10 is the answer. This is the first example to solve this. And the second one, minus 20, minus minus 10. So this minus minus then will become plus. See, minus 20 plus 10. If there is a minus sign outside the bracket, so the sign changes over here. So it will become plus 10 and then again minus plus will be minus. So 20 is the bigger number. So 20 minus 10 will be 10 and the sign of the bigger number is applied to the answer. So the answer is minus 10. So these are the two ways you can, and there are so many other ways you can find out. You can try it by yourself. Number C is saying that sum is 0. Write pairs of integers such that the answer is 0 while adding. So it's simple. 5 plus minus 5. So plus minus will be minus. So 5 minus 5 is equals to 0. Or you can write as minus 10 plus 10. So plus minus again will be minus and 10 minus 10 is equals to 0. So these are the another two example of this one. Let's go for the next one. Question number 2. Now here in this question it is saying that write a pair of negative integers whose difference gives us as answer as 8. We have to write two negative integers to get the answer as positive 8. Let's see. I have written minus 4 minus minus 12. So this minus minus will become plus. So minus 4 plus 12. And here the positive integer is bigger, so answer is going to come in positive because minus plus will be minus. So 12 minus 4 is 8. So we got the answer as 8. Question B. Write a negative integer and a positive integer whose sum is minus 5. Now we have to write one negative integer and one positive integer to get the answer as minus 5. So this is the solution, minus 10 plus 5, plus minus is minus and minus is bigger, so the answer is going to be as minus 5, 10 minus 5 is 5 and the sign is applied of the bigger number, so minus 5. So this is the solution. Third number, write a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. Now difference means subtraction. So minus 1 minus 2. This minus is of this difference and this is one negative integer and this is one positive integer and this is the difference, that is minus. So minus 1 minus 2 will be equals to minus 3 because minus minus is to be added and the sign of the bigger number, that is minus. So minus 3 is the answer. Now question number 3. What the question is saying, that in a quiz team scored minus 40, 10, 0. Team A scored this numbers and team B scored 10, 0 and minus 40. You can see all the numbers are same, but they are written bit differently. Here 40 is written first, here minus 40 is first, here minus 40 is at last, 0 is in the center over here, 0 is over here at the last, and 10 is over here at the first, where 10 is in this center. So in 3 successive rounds, which team scored more? We have to find that which team scored more. This is the first question, and then there is one another question. Can we say that we can add integers in any order? So the order of this integer is changed over here. By adding this, are we going to get the same answer? Let's see in the solution. Question 3, solution. The score of team A, as per the question, minus 40 plus 10 plus 0. Because to be added, that's why I have written plus plus. And minus 40 plus 10 will be minus 30 because negative sign is bigger, so minus 30. And what is the score of team B? Let's see. Score of team B, 10 plus 0 plus minus 40. So 10 plus 0 will be 10, and 10 minus 40 will be minus 30 because here negative sign is bigger. So can you see, we got the same answer, minus 30 for team A and minus 30 for team B. So the score of both team is same, and that's why we can say that therefore yes, we can add integers in any order. So this is the answer. Let's go on to the next one. Question number 4, fill in the blanks. Number 1, minus 5 plus minus 8 is equals to, see, minus 8 plus minus 5. What property is used over here? Commutative property. You can see that this integer, the order of the integer is changed. So while changing the order, we say that the commutative property is used over here. Number 2, minus 53 plus, there is a blank given over here, is equals to minus 53. So any number when it is added by 0 remains same, because here it is, here there is an addition. If it is added by 0, the number remains same as it is given over here. So additive identity, this is the answer. Additive identity is used over here. Number 3, 17 plus, the answer is given 0. 17 plus minus 17 is equals to 0 because 17 is minus and 17 is plus. Plus minus is minus. So 17 minus 17 is equals to 0. Again, additive inverse is used over here. This is additive identity and this is additive inverse. Number 4. You can see clearly over here in this that these two integers are grouped over here, and here last two integers are grouped over here. Answer itself is given over here, minus 7. See, these three integers are over here. So what will come in the blank? Here only two integers were given. So this is minus 7 as an answer, and this is when we group two different integers, it is called as associative property, as I have explained you in my introduction video of this chapter. You can refer it over there. The last one, minus 4 plus 15, the plus 15 and minus 3 is in the bracket, and here you can see the bracket or the integers are grouped differently, minus 4 plus 15. So answer itself is given over here, this is the answer minus 3. This is called as the associative property, same as the previous one. So here comes the end of the exercise 1.2. If you have any doubt, if you have any query, you can ask me.